sink.
Hello there, my RPG lovers, and welcome to another video. GreedFall has more than a couple of features that resemble other great RPGs, but it also manages to deliver a unique experience on its own. It doesn't require any step-to-step guide that's gonna tell you what to do, but there are stuff that I consider important or just really useful to know before you start the game, especially if you plan to play on some higher difficulty. I decided to play on Extreme for my first playthrough, which is the highest difficulty you can select before you start the game. But if you find it too difficult to handle, you can always change your mind and select some other difficulty in the menu. But you won't be my friend anymore, cause you're a little bitch. Anyway, let's get straight to the tips. Since I mentioned difficulty setting right at the start, and this is actually your first choice in the game, here is what you need to know. Easy and normal are quite different. I tested a couple of fights at every difficulty, and if you want to sit back and watch your companions destroy everything, select easy. It's not really worth mentioning that much, it's basically a story mode. Normal difficulty can still provide you a challenging fights, especially versus tougher enemies and bosses. But if the quality of your gear is high, you'll still manage to stun your opponents more frequently because their balance stat is not that great on normal. You can easily tell the difference when you use the pause menu and click on the enemy to show their stats. The higher the balance, the less chance for stunning your opponents, and same goes for your character. Your special fury attacks will also do considerably more damage on normal. And don't worry, I'll explain these stats and attacks when we get to combat tips a bit later, but I think this is not too confusing to understand so far. On hard difficulty, things get more interesting. The description here is basically on point, you'll fight more enemies in general, and they'll do more damage to you while being more aggressive as well. The thing is, you'll almost always fight more than 2 or 3 enemies, except in some rare cases. Your companions will suffer quite a bit if you don't upgrade their gear, and the higher the difficulty, the less health they'll have. Enemies will almost never stand still, so you really have to block, parry, or dodge. No matter what playstyle you go for, you'll die a lot if you just spam your attacks. All of the above can be said for the extreme difficulty as well, but to even greater extent. I never felt like this difficulty is not fair, almost every death is because I didn't time the attack properly, or I failed to get away or block. But in some cases, the difficulty spike will be really notable, especially versus the bosses and the enemies with the skull. Enemies with the skull icon above their head are much higher level than you, so it's almost a never good idea to fight them on extreme, or just in general. But it's doable if you are try hard like me. Who can stop a two-handed blade-wielding master? Yeah, anyway. Don't forget that you can always try to sneak and avoid a lot of non-quest fights. And that would pretty much cover the difficulty selection. Like I said, I encourage you to play on hard and try to stick with that difficulty throughout the whole game. Pick the class that seems interesting to you. This will just give you a couple of starting skills to use. You'll soon get more points to invest by leveling up, so don't worry too much. There's also a respect system if you want to reset everything, so you basically can't go wrong here. But you'll get one point to spend in talents and attributes as well, and some of these can give you a nice starting boost. The best option for starting attribute in my opinion is Endurance. It gives you 100 health points and some nice amount of balance. These extra health points can save your life in fights, and it's great because you're probably going to get hit more in the beginning until you learn how to fight. Also, that balance you'll get will come in handy, especially because you won't get good equipment with more balanced stats straight away. Balance is the stat that reduces the chance to get stunned or knocked down, and this attribute also allows you to wear the heaviest armors with the most beefy stats. Once you hit level 4, feel free to choose another attribute that fits your playstyle, but you can't go wrong with Endurance at the beginning. As for the talents, I would go with Vigor or Lockpicking. Vigor is really useful because it regenerates your health and mana outside the combat, and this will actually save you a lot of potions. It also allows you to pass through some passages that require balance. I've made a mistake for ignoring this at first, because it turns out there's a bunch of these places that allows you to access some really interesting areas that will usually reward you with something or just help you to get to a certain place faster. I mentioned lockpicking for the same reason basically, because I missed tons of locked chests in the beginning that could make my life easier with some nice upgraded gear and more materials. But there's a lot of loot in the game that don't require you to have this skill, and what's interesting about this, these places will actually respawn after some time so you can loot them again. But locked chests have better loot in general, and you won't actually be super rich in Greedfall unless you sell everything that you loot all the time. This is not a good idea, because you'll need those materials if you want to upgrade your gear and your companion's gear as well. But you should always sell items in the junk tab. No matter which talent you choose at the beginning, you should know that you'll find the gear that has talents on them, so it's a good idea to keep these items so you can equip them when needed. Now let's get to some combat tips. No matter what playstyle you go for, there's a couple of really important things to keep in mind when fighting. The easiest playstyle, for the beginning at least, is probably magic, because you can try to be at distance and avoid damage as much as possible. But as you progress, it will become harder, the number of enemies will increase, and you'll basically have someone at your neck all the time. And this is why I consider blocking to be really important. If you time your blocks right before the enemy is going to hit you, this counts as parry, and your character will automatically execute a counter attack. Successful parry fills up your fury bar faster than regular attacks. When you block, you won't take any damage, but you can get stunned easily if you don't have a lot of balance. It's important to understand that you can block at any given time, because you're not locked into any attack animation that you do. If you don't time your attack properly, and you see that you're gonna get hit, you can quickly press the block key to avoid taking any damage. Learning how to parry with melee attacks can be tricky, but I encourage you to try and learn this, because it's really satisfying and it pays off. I'll go in depth about this in my combat guide video that should come out soon. Magic parry works a bit different, and even though it's called magic parry, you can only block like this. There is no counter attack like when using melee weapons. I might be tripping, but blocking with magic seems more fluid at times in some cases. Blocking attacks from bosses works, you won't take any damage, but you'll usually be knocked down. As you probably imagined, dodging will be really important as well. Nothing is stopping you to dodge like a maniac all the time, but you won't be able to do any damage, especially if you're building a pure melee character. Playing with guns and magic will require you to use the dodge a bit more, but just keep in mind that aggro range is not that great in GreedFall, and you can reset the fight if you move too far away. If this happens, all the enemies will regain their health, so you'll have to fight them all over again. It's one of the things that I don't really like, but I understand why they did this. No matter what path you choose in the skill tree, I would highly recommend you to get the roll skill or lightning dash. The simple short dodge sometimes won't be enough, especially if you want to move away from a lot of enemies at once, or safely avoid a special AoE attack from beasts or bosses. Just try not to spam it a lot, because enemies will try to keep up with you, especially on hard and extreme difficulty. Another important aspect of almost every fight is armor. It's indicated by those blue shield icons, and the game tutorial will try to explain this to you. How important this stat will be depends on your playstyle. If you use magic a lot, you don't need to worry that much, because magic damage ignores all armor. However, melee weapons and firearms will have armor damage stat on them. Your enemy starts taking much more damage once you get rid of the armor. Blades have the lowest armor damage, while heavy one-handed and two-handed weapons have the highest armor damage. My character is only wielding two-handed blades, so I always look to upgrade my weapon with something that will give me higher armor damage. Another thing that you should learn at the beginning is that you have two weapon slots, so you can switch your weapons in the middle of the fight if needed. You can find use for this if you're wielding a blade and you want a heavier weapon that breaks armors more easily. Also, if you go for some hybrid like Battle Mage, you'll really find a use for this, because in one slot you can equip a divine magic ring, while in the other slot you can have some other melee weapon. Ranged weapons have their own slot, so you will only need a skill in order to use them. I used ranged weapons for my two-handed blade character only to break the opponent's armor more easily, because guns and rifles have high armor damage. It comes in handy if you don't want to switch your weapons often. Actually, once I got a better sword, I never switched my weapons, so don't worry, you're not forced to switch weapons if you don't want to. Speaking about ranged weapons, beware of the enemies who use them. It's not that hard to avoid bullets by moving behind something or someone, or blocking like we mentioned before, you just need to listen closely. When you hear that sound, just press the block button. But if you get hit, you'll take tons of damage, and it can be really annoying, especially at the beginning. You should try to focus on killing those enemies first. Now let's talk about attacking and the fury system. Your every attack, block or parry will build your fury bar. This stat on weapons will tell you how much fury you gain with each attack. At 50%, you can use the special attack with the weapon that you're currently wielding. This special attack will be different depending on the weapon that you're using. At 100%, you can use the same special attack multiple times, or use a powerful skill that consumes all fury, but you'll first need to unlock those powerful skills from the skill tree. The special fury attack does increase damage, with high chance to unbalance weaker enemies. Your hands will glow yellow at 50% and red at 100%. Different weapons will use different amounts of fury for the special attack, and you'll find this stat right over here. You can build your whole playstyle around the Fury system if you wish, but more on that in the combat video. And the last combat tip for this video is the pause menu. I almost never use it to be honest, but it can be a powerful tool, especially in some tougher fights. You can basically hotkey everything in GreedFall and you'll use the pause menu to do this. I don't like to break the action, so I don't use it very often. That being said, I use it sometimes to see the enemy stats. And now, I'll give you some random tips that are on top of my mind. I recommend crafting for all playthroughs because it's really interesting and powerful. Keep your eyes open for the ores that you can find in the open areas, because without intuition talent it can sometimes be harder to notice them, especially the one that you can find on the ground. You will start the game with 200 inventory limit, but don't let this stop you from picking up everything. It's not that easy to go above that limit, especially in the beginning, and even if you do, you just won't be able to sprint. Sell or recycle those extra armor pieces that you don't need, and one talent that can be really useful for this is the craftsmanship level 2. It allows you to recycle your gear without needing to find a crafting table. When traveling between areas, you'll be placed at a camp that allows you to choose your companions, do some crafting, and visit a merchant. This merchant will always have different items, so make sure you check his inventory every time you're here. Every side quest will be chained to a couple of more quests. Once you reach a certain point in some of the side quests, you will need to progress the main quest a little bit in order to continue. And this usually happens because you didn't unlock a certain zone. The island of Tirfra D will open up more as you do quests, and I advise you to explore everything once you unlock a new area. There are missions that you can find in some zones on the notice boards, and these missions usually work as the contracts in The Witcher 3, where you fight some big monsters. And these are the simplest form of optional quests in the game, but those monsters are really worth fighting. Main and side quests are really well done for the most part, and you'll have a couple of options to progress. Can't really talk a lot without spoiling too much. Since you'll almost always have a couple of main quests, they will usually send you to a different locations on the island. I've met one of my companions after 26 hours in the game because I ignored one main quest and did a lot of side quests and some exploring. Weaker enemies will respawn and you won't need to fight them if you don't need their materials, so you can sneak by or just run. Every time your reputation with some of the factions increases, you'll get a good quality item waiting for you in your storage. You can find your storage at your house in every major city, camps, and every camp in the woods when you travel between the zones. If you want to keep your companions alive at higher difficulty, you'll absolutely need to get them some better gear. But you don't have to buy the gear and waste money, you can just give them what you find or just upgrade their existing gear. Don't be afraid when upgrading your gear, you'll find plenty of materials while exploring and recycling the gear that you find. Don't forget to loot everything, especially in the cities, and once you come back, check again for that yellow glow because like I said before, they will usually respawn. That would be some general tips that are on top of my mind. I purposely avoided to talk a lot about the story options and quests in general to avoid any spoilers. You don't need any step-by-step guide, these tips are meant to help you a bit, especially if you go with a hard or extreme difficulty. In my next videos about GreedFall, we'll focus more on things like combat, talents and the gear. I hope these tips help you to understand how things work, and be sure to subscribe for more in-depth guides, news and reviews. I make videos about RPGs, so if you're into those games, you'll find something for you. Special thanks to my patrons and YouTube exclusive members, and if you as well want to join them, all the links are in the description. See ya in the next one.